আজকে যে জিনিসটা নিয়ে ডিসকাশন করব সেটা ক্লাস 7 এবং ক্লাস 9 এর সিবিএসই বোর্ডের সিএএস এর জন্য পারফেক্ট তো একটাই কথা বলবো পারলে যদি ভালো লাগে ভিডিওটা লাইক দিয়ে দিও আর সাবস্ক্রাইব করে রেখো আর পারলে বেল আইকনটা টিপে রাখো সো টুডে আই উইল ডিসকাস অ্যাবাউট দ্য কনগ্রুয়েন্সি ফর দ্য ট্রায়াঙ্গেল এন্ড হুইচ ইজ ইন ইউর সিলেবাস ফর ক্লাস 7 এন্ড 9 সো ইউ নো দ্যাট হোয়াট ইজ কনগ্রুয়েন্সি বা হোয়াট ইজ কনগ্রুয়েন্ট ইফ Suppose this and this are two pages, this one is a page and this one is a page and these two are same. And this, if we join together, then they are coincide to each other. Then that means the previous page and the new page are same. So we can say that these two are congruent. So today I'll discuss about the congruency for the triangle. So how many things are there? Suppose this is a triangle and here A, B, C are three vertices and this is a triangle. So we can say that here how many things are there? So first we can write A, angle A, angle B and angle C. 1, 2, 3. Three angles are there and also they are given A, B, B, C and C, A. So here basically angle and sides are there. So angle and sides are there. And the previous class will discuss about the construction, how to construct a triangle. So minimum three things are required. That is side, angle, side. That means one side is given and then angle is given and then side is given. Then you can construct a triangle. So basically, congruence property is that if you can construct any kind of triangle, perfect triangle, then this is the major things, but this can be used for prove the congruence. So, how many probability, how many possibilities are there by using A and S? We have taken only three parts. So, we can write side, side, side. This is one possibility. Side, side, side. Okay. Number two, side, angle, side. Number three, angle, side, side. Sorry, angle, side, angle. Number four, angle, angle, side. Side, angle, angle. 6. So we can write active through. So angle, angle, side, 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 side. Then side, side, angle. 7. Angle, side, side. Number 8. Angle, angle, angle. So there are, we can basically we can write by using S and A, there are 8 possibilities. Now we are going to check which one is the congruent property. So by using these three, if we can construct any triangle, then this will be the congruent property. This is the main thing you have to mind. So when three sides are given, then we can construct a triangle. How? Suppose one side is given and another two sides is, if we cut an arc and another side by cut an arc and if we join, then this form a triangle. So S is the congruent property. So S is the congruent property. Then come to the next point, that is side, angle, side. Suppose one side is given, this is side, and then angle is given. So by using protractor or divider or something else, if you have any kind of measurement for drawing the angles, and you can construct an angle. Suppose the angle is 60 degrees, then you can construct like this and then this, and this will be 60 degrees. So side, and you then you get the angle, and next side is given. So you can cut by using divider, and after joining side, angle, side, you can construct the perfect triangle. So side, angle, side is the congruent property. Next is angle, side, angle. That means one side is given and another two side, another two angles are lies in the two end. So this is the side, and next two angles are like that and another like that. If we produce two lines, then they meet at a point, so we get a perfect triangle. So this is that. So this is the congruent property. Next, angle, angle, side. So one side is given and this, then angle is given. So since here given angle, angle, side, so this is side, this is angle. So next angle, that is the first angle, obviously lies in this, in that point, in that vertex. So but we cannot construct this angle. How? Why? Because this length is not given. So we can measure this angle out, 180 degree minus this angle plus this angle, then you can construct this height, this angle. If you construct, but you can draw, then this form a triangle, except triangle. So angle, angle, side also are congruency for showing, congruency for proving two triangles are congruent. And similarly, this also side, angle, angle. So this is side, this side is angle, this side is angle, but we cannot draw here. That's why we can measure in that side. Okay, so these heights are congruent. Now let's come to the last 3 points, that is side, side, angle. So when, this is very important things, when two sides given and then angle is given, that means at first one side is given and another side is given, and the after side, after side, after SSA, so this side is S, this side is S, and this side is angle. So at first we construct the angle SS, and the next, and the next, attention please, to amra eta eta amra use korchi ei modhe jodi nei ei palta to bhi amra dekhachi cholo. So this height is given. Now suppose you can just we assume that the this side is like that, this length is the side of that side. So we are cutting at the point. If we cut, then I mean that matter that can go right, that is sweet. If we cut, then this line is cut at 2 points. Okay, because this side, in that side, side, another side, 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 side A. So this side is also lies in that side. So this length can be cut at 2 points. So we can construct the line. Then look here, this also a triangle. Again, this also a triangle. So we can't construct perfect triangle because here two triangles form. So this property is not the congruent property. Similarly, for this, one angle is given, angle is first in that side, then side, then this side is cut. If you cut, then this part and the 2 points. If you joined, then here this also a triangle and this also a triangle. So this also not the congruent property. Now come to the last point. Now come to the last point. This is angle, angle, angle. Three angles are given. Okay. Acha, if we construct an equilateral triangle, in that case, this angle, this angle, this angle are same. 60 degree, 60 degree,
60 degree.
So three angles are same.
Again, if we construct another equilateral triangle, this also 60, this also 60, this also 60. Another construct triangle, this also 60, 60, 60. So these three angles are 60.
So can you say that all triangles are same coincide?
No.
This is the similarity.
Similarity, not congruence.
So angle is not the congruent property because we cannot construct exact triangle.
Now come to the point. This is side angle and ASS is not the congruent property, but in which condition this is the congruent property? That means in which condition we can construct exact triangle.
If side angle is given, okay,
so one side is given, if the angle is obtuse,
the angle is obtuse,
that is more than 90, in that case you can construct an exact triangle. Why? Because this side is given, na? If we construct this, then this line cut at only one point, then this form the exact triangle. So in which case this is angle side angle side. So when angle is obtuse angle, in that time you can construct a triangle. Again, you can say that if the length, this length is less than this length, কোন একটা ট্রায়াঙ্গেল যদি এই লেন্থ খাইতে সব থেকে বড় হয় অন্যগুলো তুলনায়, তাহলে কিন্তু তুমি একটা এক্সাক্ট ট্রায়াঙ্গেল কনসেপ্ট করতে পারো। সেটা আমাদের কনসেপচুয়াল ব্যাপার। তো এই আমরা কনগ্রুয়েন্সিতে সাইড অ্যাঙ্গেল অ্যাঙ্গেল সাইডটা ইউজ করি না, আমরা একটা স্পেশাল জিনিস ইউজ করি, সেটা হলো এই দুটোরই ভাই কেমন না। এই দুটোকে বেসিক্যালি আমরা যখন বলে দিচ্ছি যে right angle hypotenuse side, you can say that here right angle, one angle is given, then hypotenuse, this also side and this is side, this also side. So if you compare for this angle side is given, then this is the congruent property, but this is in generally known, but RHS is the special case for ASS. So next, 9th is the point where RHS is the congruent property. So, if the question is, there are how many congruent properties? So, how many properties are there to prove the two triangles are congruent? So, there are basically 5. One is side. Number 2, angle side. Number 3, angle. Number 4, angle side. Number 5, RHS. আমরা angle সাইড or সাইড angle, these two are same, সুতরাং আমরা একটা মানে লিখেছি। So these 5 are congruent property. So আমরা একটা অঙ্ক, ছোট্ট একটা অঙ্ক দেখাই যেটা খুব ইম্পর্টেন্ট, খুবই কাজে লাগে বেসিক্যালি। তো তোমরা এটা একটা কাজ করতে পারো, এই যে ভিডিওগুলো তোমরা করছি, তো যদি তোমরা মনে করো যে আমি এটা খাতায় নোট করবো, পজ করে করে, ঠিক আছে, পজ করে তারপর তোমরা নিজেরা কিন্তু সবাই করে নিতে পারবে। তো আমি একটা বলছি, তোমরা যদি পারো খাতায় লিখে নেবে পজ করে করে, সেটা হলো ফর অ্যান আইসোসেলিস ট্রায়াঙ্গেল প্রুভ দ্যাট অপোজিট সাইড অফ ইকুয়াল অ্যাঙ্গেলস আর ইকুয়াল। বললাম ফর অ্যান আইসোসেলিস ট্রায়াঙ্গেল opposite side of equal angles are equal. Suppose this is the triangle And given that this and this are same, now you have to prove that given B angle is equal to C angle. Now you have to prove that AB is equal to AC. How? It had a construction with the construction. Construction. Now just AD is perpendicular to BC. AD is perpendicular to BC. The construction. Now there are two triangles, this and this. The two triangles. Now, if you compare these two triangles, then triangle ABD and triangle ACD. There are two triangles. So we have to prove that these are congruent. আমরা যদি এটা এটা কনক্লুড বলে দিতে পারি তাহলে এই সাইডের সঙ্গে এই সাইড ম্যাচ করে গেল, এটার সাথে এটা ম্যাচ করে গেল, এটা যদি একই হয়ে যায় তাহলে এটা কনক্লুড। তাহলে এখানে কি বলেছিল, এই অ্যাঙ্গেলটা এটা সমান, তাহলে এটা সেম দেয় এরকম দাগ দিয়েছি, দেখেছো সেম দাগ দিয়েছি। সো হিয়ার বি অ্যাঙ্গেল ইজ ইকুয়াল টু সি অ্যাঙ্গেল, এ ডি বি অ্যাঙ্গেল, দিস অ্যাঙ্গেল ইজ 90 বিকজ উই কনস্ট্রাক্ট অ্যাজ আ পারপেন্ডিকুলার and this equal to A, D, C. So these two are same, and if the right here, this equal to 90 degree, and this is given, and you can say AD is common. So here angle, angle, side by angle, side congruent. Triangle A, B, D. This is the congruent sign. এখানে একটা জিনিস বলি, আমরা congruent triangle করতে গেলে কিন্তু যে triangleটাকে আমরা রাখবো না, ওই triangleএর যে vertexের সঙ্গে যে vertex মিলছে ওটা একটা সুবিধা। Suppose for these two triangles, A angle and A, this side A angle is same, so we have to write first is A. Since B angle and C angle same, so this is B, so here we have to write C, and this is D, so D, so this also D. Since these two are congruent by CPCT, what is the meaning of CPCT? Congruent part of corresponding part of congruent triangle. By mistake, corresponding part of congruent triangle. So this is the congruent. The corresponding part, the intercept is the same, S and the A same, S and the A same. So these are same. Well, by CPCT, we can say that AB is equal to AC. Good. Okay. So, আমি একটু জুম করে এটাকে ভালো করে একটু স্ট্রে করে রাখছি, ঠিক আছে? তোমাদের বোঝার সুবিধা তোমরা এটাকে স্ক্রিনশটও নিয়ে নিতে পারো, স্ক্রিনশট নিয়েও তোমরা এটাকে ভালোভাবে করতে পারবে। তো আমি এবার কিছু কনগ্রুয়েন্সির ব্যাপারে কিছু কনসেপ্ট দিই। তো মোটামুটি এটা 20 মিনিটের কাছাকাছি ভিডিও হয়ে গেছে, তোমরা দেখতে গোলগুলি করবে। তো আমি এর পরের ভিডিওতে আরো কিছু এর প্রবলেম নিয়ে আসছি, তো তোমরা তার জন্য অপেক্ষা করে থাকো, আর সাবস্ক্রাইব করতে ভুলো না, ঠিক আছে? আর ঘন্টাটা বাজিয়ে দিও তোমাদের কাছে তাড়াতাড়ি আসার জন্য। তো চলো আজকের মতো এইটুকুই, পরের জন্য তোমরা অপেক্ষা করো। টাটা।